Have a look at this code. A self-documented code, isn't it? At first glance, most of will say that this C++ code will definitely throw errors.
It will.
But surprisingly, it runs without any errors and keeps printing E in the terminal.
How?
A single semicolon can mess up a program. Yet here we are, just seeing a bunch of E's and then also this code works. It almost feels like someone broke the rules of C++ entirely, right? But trust me, there's a logical explanation for all of this. So let's decode this in very simple words. In CPP, this hashtag include IOStream is used to include the input-output stream library, which has functions that let us print stuff in the terminal. Then we have hashtag define, which defines a macro. A macro is basically just a piece of code. In this case, E is the macro name and this is the piece of code. So whenever we use E in the code, during compilation, it gets replaced with the code defined for it. Now, the person who wrote this code decided to turn every part of the code into a multiple of E's. When the program runs, all those E's get replaced with an actual code they represent. For example, one E gets replaced with the word using. Two E's turn into namespace. Three E's turn into std. And in the same way, we can replace all the E's with their respective word. And we get the understandable code where the main function is using a while loop to continuously print E using the cout and cerror objects. And that's how we end up with E showing up in the terminal. It's pretty amazing when you think about it. A series of simple letters transforming into a working program. Oh, and fun fact, there's actually a GitHub repo where someone created a code to print E continuously in a bunch of different programming languages.